Today is April the 11th, 2014, Mother's Day. And we thank you for taking the time out of your day to spend with the Greater New Hope Church International. Today, Holy Spirit messenger is Pastor Charles McDaniel. The Holy Spirit message is entitled, Ask God to Strengthen Our Hands, Part 2. We will be coming from the old text, Nehemiah chapter 6, verse 9 in the King James Version. Our new text will be 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10. Nehemiah 6 and 9 reads, For they all made us afraid, saying, Their hands shall be weakened from the work, that it be not done. Now therefore, O God, strengthen my hands. 1 Peter, But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, make ye perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you. We will be reading 2 Samuel chapter 22, verses 21, 2 Samuel 22, verse 35, Psalms 18, verse 20, Psalms 68, verse 28, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 17. Again, we thank you for joining us. Please open your hearts and minds to be fed and filled with the Word of God. Know that the Lord gives strength unto his people, and the Lord blesses his people with peace. Psalms 29, 11. Once again, the title is, Ask God to Strengthen Our Hands, Part 2. Happy Mother's Day, everyone.
Ask God to strengthen our hands. I want to read a few verses, the text, and then I want to use this Mother's Day to launch us into what God is really asking of his people. We can do all things,
yes.
The Bible says, through Christ,
yes.
Which strengthens us. We learned that during that time Nehemiah was building the wall, and
yes.
Old Sam Ballard came by, and old political folks trying to talk him off the wall. Nothing has changed.
Right.
And the ninth verse says, They all made us afraid. Too many times we let the world. Hi, Mama Long, Lord, I didn't see you back there. Good morning, baby. How you doing? Lord, have mercy. That's all right. Hallelujah. Good. Woo. And they all made us afraid. You're going to understand this a little better. We move along. Saying, their hands shall be weakened from work, that it be not done. Now, therefore, Nehemiah said, oh, God, strengthen my hands. And we must understand, wherever we are, the grace of God can reach you.
Amen.
That's right.
I want y'all to hear that now. I didn't say it, but the God of
all grace.
That means whatever grace you need, he got it.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
The God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus.
Uh-huh.
And nothing just common to man. I mean, we go through stuff. And he says, after that, you have suffered a while. And some say, hey, when you see that first look into heaven, this ain't going to be about nothing. You ain't went through nothing. Make you mature.
Yes, Lord.
Establish. Strengthen, settle you. It settles you down when you know who you are.
Yes, it does, Pastor. Say yes, it does.
And who paid the price.
Thank you.
Yes, Lord.
And you see, too many times, we're not to be nobody's doormat because we're Christians.
Yes, Lord.
Now, you got to understand that the world is trying to make you afraid. They're trying to push every different lifestyle upon you.
Yes.
But now, that's all right. They got to pay the price, but I got to tell them what God said.
Amen.
And sometimes we have to understand God will give you righteous indignation and you will deal with some things as he leads you. 2 Samuel 22 and 35, it says very plain, he teacheth my hands to war. I want every serviceman, don't let no Bible thumping folks telling you a murderer and stuff like that. I heard that, and that's the most sickening thing. Yes, and the very fact that that soldier left some of his mother's and wives and stuff, and fought for you, so you could say that to him, even though you shouldn't say it to him.
Yes,
but you didn't appreciate it, see? So sometimes God will teach your hands how to make war, yes, so that a bow of steel. I'm like, y'all understand what he's saying. Say, when I endue you with power, you can break a bow of steel.
Well, I
don't think they really understand. That's on record where mothers saw their child underneath the car. And they're not going to lift the whole car. Y'all forgot about what Samson did. I'm going to leave that. Y'all know what I'm saying. Hey, glory. But Lord, I got to tell you what God said. And that's in Psalm 18 and 20. It says, the Lord, Yahweh, YHWH, God, our Father, you asked him, reward me according to my righteousness.
Well, Lord.
You hear what I didn't write this, y'all. According to the cleanliness of my hands have he recompensed me. In other words, he gave me guess what I sowed.
Right.
In that words, I don't care if you're in the Lord or out of it. Whatsoever, what the book say, whatsoever you sow, you're going to get it back. Huh? That's what the book says. And see, this is how we want to live, and I would encourage you to live. That's in Psalm 68 and 28. It says, thy God, is it your God? If you can claim that, thy God has commanded thy strength. But I want you to hear this now. See, we get so weak-minded when God tells us to do something. But it says, strengthen, O God, that which thou has wrought for us. You ought to hear what the Lord said. He's already done it. You have to ask him that, and you got to understand that he in charge. And understand Philippians 4 and 13 really does mean what it says. I, very personal, can do all things through Christ, which what strengtheneth me. I can't do what I do without his strength. I don't believe y'all believe me when I say the only time I'm out of pain is when I'm up here delivering the word. I can't stand at home long as I'm standing now. My folks know that, but that's all right. Go with me now, this is for mothers. I want you. And it does not exclude anyone.
Yes, sir.
Go with me to Mark, the third chapter.
Wow.
We're going to commence at the 31st verse. Mm. Then you'll begin to understand. It says, not in Psalm 1, not unto us, O Lord, not unto to us, but unto thy name give glory, for thy mercy and for thy truth's sake. That's Psalm 115:1, y'all. See, that's all we got to do. Now, look what it says here. Mothers, I want you to hear. Fathers, I want you to hear. Folks, it's not brothers and sisters, I want you to hear, because this is God saying, you got to answer this question. And when you can answer this question, you're on your way to a better place. You're on your way to a better life. He said it, not me. 31 said, see, he had just cast out devils and all kind of stuff.
Yes.
And then all the run. You don't realize that Jesus' natural brothers and sisters thought he was crazy. He heard the people say, he got a devil. Oh, they'll tell you, you ain't doing nothing. Ain't nothing new. Tell them, have a nice trip. Then look what it says in 31st. There came then, number one, his brethren and his mother. On the cross, Christ, he told his disciples, behold thy mother. Now, I want you to get some sure enough out of this now. And standing without, sent unto him, calling him. And let me get my boy out of that. Let me get my brother out of that. He both think it's crazy. And we kind of think it too. 32. And the multitude, now listen, the multitude that sat about him, just like you're doing today. And they said unto him, behold thy mother. Notice it's a conjunction. And thy brother without seeketh for thee. But now we need to seek him, but for the right reason.
Amen.
Hey, you know, they try to seek you just like the world. Somebody try to seek you to shut you down. And that's probably what they didn't mean no harm, but they know at this time. And here's the question. And he answered them, well, everybody hear this now, saying, who is my mother or my brother? And he looked round about on them which sat about him,
no, sir,
and said, behold my mother and my brethren. But now he said, whoa, for a minute here. Now this is how I get that transition. When he said, who, for whosoever, that's all inclusive, here's the prerequisite, shall do the will of God. I'm going to say it again. The will of God. Then said, in then saith is my, the same is, present tense. I'm a little happy this morning, y'all. But it, I did, saying, this is my brother, notice it, and my sister, and mother. If we begin to internalize this, when we begin to do the will of God, whether you be male or female,
amen. Amen.
When you start seeing that, you don't look at everybody the same way, like you're going to judge somebody. You don't begin to allow that your flesh, see, six packs or whatever, and the men, and you begin to see women as God wants you to see, as a gift to you. Y'all better hear that this morning.
Yes, yes,
you see,
yes.
Because the world will always, and haven't stopped, will always try to put women down.
Yes.
Go out of other countries. They put their women down. But that's going against the will of God. It doesn't matter. You have to be as a mother, as a father, as a sister or a brother. You must do the will of God. You know, when you do the will of God, then you don't have no problem asking God, strengthen my hands. I got something to do. You told me, you wrought it for me, now give me the strength to do it. He'll give me the bricks and all I need, but I must build it. Then we want to go back. That's what Nehemiah was saying, but sometimes there is, in God's word, a realistic fire. I know everybody know about it. And a trial. Then let's go to that. Daniels. We won't be that long because I don't want everybody getting with their mamas today. That's all right. But before we go there, these men had to do this. And that's in Ephesians 6 and 11. And we must do it. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. It hasn't changed. He can do nothing to you, but he can seduce you. That's what he did to Mother Eve. But we wrestle not against flesh and blood. A lot of us don't realize. We get upset. I tell them, you don't let them see you sweat, but against principality. against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand in the evil day, having done all to stand. And this is what Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego did.
That's what it is.
And you got to understand something in Daniel's 3 and 8, we're going to start it. And I want you to begin to see something here. This is an exact, it hadn't changed, copy of what the world tries to do unto children of God. Now, you got to understand something. That's not their name. That, you know, that's what Nebuchadnezzar gave to him.
Yeah.
It's like the world tried to tell you, you evolved from apes. Okay, but let's go what the word says in Psalm 139 and 14. When you realize that, you said, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are the works, and that my soul knoweth right well. This is the time you really getting down where the rubber meets the road. When you acknowledge him, you're willing to do the will of God regardless of what somebody else is saying or what the world is saying. I don't care. I'm not down to anybody. Hey, God has already spoken. I'm not going to say anymore. He said it's an abomination. Homosexuality. Now, I don't care how much the world try to put down. I'll accept it. That's fine. But they the one got to pay for it. And I have never seen in all my years. But see, we got to understand something. Satan is the prince and power of the air. So that's why on the television screen, you see all kind of weirdness pushing an agenda. But now, here's the agenda we must have, and you'll find it in these few verses. Let's get going. Wherefore, listen now, and they, wherefore, at that time, certain Chaldeans came near and accused the Jews. Them old Christian folks and Jews, they're homophobic.
Well,
have y'all heard that word before?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, you know, I hate the lifestyle. I love the person.
That's right.
They spake and said to the king Nebuchadnezzar, listen now, O king, live forever. That is the absolute method of operation of Satan. He's going to always try to flatter you.
Yeah, right.
He ain't quit. No. Young ladies, no. You'll always find some dude, a young man, whatever, a woman trying to flatter you. Thou king, listen now, thou king has made a decree. And they understand once they make a decree, that's it.
Yes.
There's certain, you don't understand, now listen now, that every man that shall hear the sound of the cornet, the flute, the harp, the sackbut, the psalms, the psalm string, and the dulcimer, and all, listen, but and all kinds of music. Get hold of that, young folk. They putting out now that there's going to be a program on there talking about hip-hop music, that they got the message. That's what it's called, the message. And they're espousing their gospel. There's nothing wrong if you're strong enough in the Lord, you can listen to it. But all types of music, you have to understand, music influences the soul. You have to control your ear gate. Now look what it said. Shall fall down and worship the golden image. I've seen people totally transformed just by music. young ladies lose their dignity, and so does young men.
Yeah.
They let the music take over them and don't realize that everything is flying one way or the other, and you're just out there going. All modesty is lost. Now remember, it was lost because not that necessarily that's who you were, but that music took over. But see, look what he said. And whosoever falleth not down and worship. So you got the worship rap music. They got all their icons. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And many of them are dead. Tupac Shakur, whatever it is, that big, whatever, something. All of them. But you don't see the end results of that. What did God say? The wages of sin, what does it produce? You need to see that. Yes, it may look like they ride around in big-time cars and they make stuff with boats. But let me explain something. I was in the music. Everything you see on that video, they rented it. Don't own it. Some of them dudes riding around in some stuff in a video and don't even have a place to stay. They're living with their mama. And yet you believe that. And I know what I'm talking about now. That he should be cast into the midst of a burning, fiery furnace. Now that there's a mindset here, beloved, that everybody ought to get hold to. You hear what I'm saying? There are certain Jews. They want to single you out. The world will single you out. They will use politics. They will try to break. Fine, they can do all they want. But you remember, I'm more than the whole world. It don't matter. You stick to my word. I take care of my own. Then are certain Jews who has set over the affairs of the providence of Babylon. See, they have to understand now. Here's some captives that God stepped in because he knows that's my child. And these politicians don't like it. There's a lot of times you'll be put in a position on your job that folks ain't going to like it. Tell them have a nice trip. Because God put you there. And I don't care what nobody say. And it might look good. Well, Fortune 500 company, Babylon. And I mean, one of the gardens was one of the 8 wonders of the world. Everything looks good. But it may not be good. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These men, O king, have not regarded thee. They serve not thy gods. They ain't doing what you have decreed. That's politicking. They ain't getting with us on this program, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. And they tricked him into doing that. That's what politics will do to you. Then Nebuchadnezzar, in his rage and fury, commanded to bring Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Then they brought these men before the king. And the king got all religious. He said, Nebuchadnezzar spake and said unto them, is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, do not ye serve my gods? Aren't you with the program? Nor worship the golden image which I have set up? Like question. And you know how much I've done for y'all. I didn't give you the education. I did all things. I brought you up. Even half of my name is Nebo, mean the God of learning. I'm trying to help you now, boy. Now if you be ready that at what time you hear the sound of the cornet, notice he's repeating everything back, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, the dulcimer, and all kinds of music, ye fall down and worship the image. Come on now. No, you can go along with the program. You know, you don't have to bother. You don't have to say nothing. You know, they ain't hurt nobody. But if you love somebody, you want to let them know what they're doing is not good. Which I have made. Now notice, which I have made. When you analyze it, they made up this in their own mind. Whatever. He made it. A man made something. You don't worship that.
Never, Pastor.
That I made. Well, but if ye worship not, you shall be cast the same hour into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. And who is that God that shall deliver you out of my hands?
Lord.
You don't do what I say, I'm going to fire you. So, you don't have to worry about it. Now, that's pretty much what they said. And now look at the 16th verse. I like the way the Lord used 16 verse, 3:16. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Now listen, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. My mind's made up.
Well, yes, Lord.
I don't care how much pressure you put on me. I don't care about what you say you're going to do unto me. We're not careful to answer you in this body, in this matter. If it be so, listen now, listen. Folks, they get all excited, but they got to understand the principle, the etymology. If it be so, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thy hand, O King. But here, you don't have to worry about it. Absent from the body is present with the Lord. But he said, but if not, I don't care what you say, if not, be it known unto thee, be it known unto you. You can shake your finger at me all you want to. Be it known unto you, O King, that we will not serve thy gods. I'm not going to ride with you because you got a Mercedes with gold stripes on and get my and lose my credibility because I want to get ride in a car that some man made. When God can give you that and much more. We will not serve thy gods, nor worship thy golden image, which thou hast set up. Y'all hear that now? Then was Nebuchadnezzar full of fury. He flipped out. He lost his mind. And the form of his vestige was changed again. Now, he was talking real sweet to him before. As long as you're on the program, baby, everything all right. I mean, we're going to take care of you. Go and do what you want, you know. Ain't no big deal. But when you didn't do it and you stuck to your guns, yeah, they get upset. So, change against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Therefore, he spake and commanded that they should heat. And that's where he made a mistake here. Y'all don't realize that. But see, if you knew biblical mathematics, is that they should heat the furnace once. 7 times more than it was wont to be heated. And he said 7 times. He made a mistake. That's God's number of completion. You know God's going to come and see by the child. Y'all don't hear nobody. Lord, have mercy. You see, we must understand, no matter how somebody try to turn up the heat on you, be aware of what's going on. 20 verse, and he commanded that the most mighty man, it's got his shock troops. I mean, his great force, the well-trained ones, his mighty men that were in his army to bind, listen now, to bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and to cast them into the burning fiery furnace. Now, that ain't common. I mean, that's what I'm saying. Fiery trials going to come. But some things, you got to know the difference of just coming. If you get a hangnail, don't be hollering, God, fix my hangnail. That's going to be something that's just common. But when you feel that enemy trying to come in, which you have authority over, then you get your back up and say, Jesus, I'm stepping back. You take care of it. That's all you got to do. Now, look, you're going to see this. Then, listen now, 21st. Then these men were bound in their coats. They don't want, hey, I know that little stuff y'all got on. We know what it's made out. They're going to burn up quick.
That's right,
Pastor. Y'all have their hosen and their hat. And their other garments and were cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Y'all better hear this next verse, though. This is shouting grace. That's why we want to get the word, see. Therefore, because the king, now notice the king's commandment was urgent and the furnace exceedingly hot, the flames of the fire slew.
Yes, Lord.
God started fighting immediately, didn't he? Slew the men that took Shadrach, that took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. You see what I'm saying? Now listen. And the three men. And these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down, bound into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. All of my ass, y'all believe it's all this, beloved?
Well,
it can't
yes,
happen.
Sir.
God
yes,
can
sir.
Do things that you can't even wrap your mind up. Then Nebuchadnezzar, listen now, the king was astonished. Now, I done saw this fire blow away my stock troops, and I'm looking and rose up in haste and spake and said unto the counselors, all the boys tricked him, you know, counselors, did we, I like that he brought them all in because they got to go before the judgment seat. Did we not cast three men bound into the midst of the fire? They answered and said unto the king, O king. But look what happened, God. He answered and said, and lo, I see four men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt. And the form of the fourth, don't tell me folks don't know what God is. See, they know when God is coming, they don't want to acknowledge it, is like, never acknowledge it, the Son of God. And do you know, I won't bore you with the rest, I encourage you to read. Do you know not even their hair had smoke on it? The only thing the fire did was burn off the bounds.
Well,
they walked out there loose. And not even the smell of nothing on them. Blew the king's mind. That's where you and I have to begin to trust God to do in your life. Yes, trouble comes, beloved. But we don't have to sit down and be without hope, Paul says.
Amen.
It doesn't matter now whether you male, female. The only way you can really be the mother, the brother, the sister, of Jesus. I know you wonder why the pastor said, my big brother Jesus.
Yes.
You understand that? He said, for whosoever shall do the will of God, the same is my brother.
Yes.
And my sister. And my mother. On this Mother's Day, I hope many of you will begin to internalize not what I said,
Amen. But
what God said. And I'm going to read this now. God is just so awesome. He uses certain verse declarations, like Ephesians 3 and 16. I'm closing with this. If you know, Ephesians, 3rd chapter, 16th verse. I may have read that to you, but I want you to understand that this thing about being strengthening has nothing to do with what goes on the outside. Those men did not try to do anything outwardly, but they had an inner strength that it didn't matter, King. We ain't got no problem telling you, we ain't bowing down. And I pray this, that on this Mother's Day and every day, that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might by his Spirit. Don't let nobody try to turn God into no ghost. He ain't no ghost. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Strengthen you with might by the Spirit, where? In the inner man. Your body, your clay pot, is the temple for the Holy Spirit. The Bible says we have his treasure in earthen vessels. When we acknowledge that and begin to read God's word, then we begin to understand there's nuggets of truth in there that all God has ever asked us to do is, read it. He didn't say you have to understand it, because he's the only one that can teach it. I'm just his mouthpiece. But you got to say, keep me, oh Lord, from the hands of the wicked. You have to say that. I can't do it for you.
Amen. Amen.
And you got to do what it said. Then I said unto the Lord, thou art my God. Hear my voice. Hear my supplication, O God.
Yes, Lord.
Hear it. You understand the tenderness and God's feeling your emotion. He has emotions too.
Yes, he does.
When you come to him, he said, if it's coming from the heart, what does it do? It reaches the heart.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
My supplication is personal.
Oh, yes.
You don't have to tell me. You can tell me only what you want to, but I can't do anything about it but pray for you.
Well, Lord.
Some of you got some problems with you think some evil man. All I'm going to tell you is read Psalm 140. And you'll find out, and this applies to everyday life. Because you're going to run into proud folks. They're going to try to say, I got it going on. No, they don't. God can punch their lights out just like he can yours.
Yes.
Father, we thank you for the privilege of serving you on this Mother's Day.
Yes, Lord.
We pray that your word has fallen on good ground.
Yes.
That it doesn't matter who we are. Jesus gave us the answer. That if we would just do the will of God as best we can, he said, then you become my mother, my brother, and my sister. Now, has God left anything out? No, Father, you haven't. You love your creation. you told us you don't have to do all this stuff. He said, I want your love. I want your mercy. And I want you to have the knowledge of God in your heart. I told you to hide it, that you sin not against me. As he spoke to his other disciples, let not your heart be troubled.
Yes, Lord.
Just believe in me. In God also.
Yes, Lord.
Because I have never done anything but what my Father told me to do. When you realize that Emmanuel really means God with us.
Yes, Lord.
He's here to love us. He's here to keep us. He's to lead us in righteousness.
Yes, yes.
For his name's sake.
For his name, yes.
And I know, folks, whatever your yea, though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death,
yes,
shall fear no evil. For thou art with me.
Yes,
thy rod and thy staff it comfort me.
Yes, Lord.
Thou preparest a table for me before my enemies. I promise, and you promised us that you would, and it's like you would make your enemies a footstool. With Christ-like, he'll make our enemies our footstool.
Yes.
But now don't hate your enemy. He said, pray for them. Love them right where they are, Father, didn't he? And it's like keeping hot coals upon their neck. In other words, the hounds of heaven begin to get on their trail. They'll either come to God or they'll be on their own.
Yes.
Father, we thank you for your love.
Yes,
we thank you for your understanding. We thank you for the fact that you've given us all the details for living on this second earth age in this book. Just obey it. You told our women and mothers and whomever to dress in modest apparel, and it applies to young men too.
Yes, it does.
And so you talk to your mothers and fathers, don't exacerbate your child, but bring them up. Teach them to love me, respect me, while you're eating at the dinner table. Why do you think the enemy got us going in all different directions? One eating McDonald's up in the bedroom, the other eating fish down in the kitchen, the other eating looking at TV. No, God wants us to come together.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
More than just on Mother's Day. Every day that God bless you with food to put in our mouth, Father, we thank you. Lord, we praise you. We thank you for my family here today.
Yes.
We thank you for my New Hope family.
Yes, Lord.
And I hope they heard you, Father.
Yes.
And Lord, to see mother-in-law, God, thank you. It's good to see her here today.
Yes, Lord.
These and all blessings we ask in Yeshua Messiah's name. And let every heart say, amen.
Amen.